today we're going to make Stephanie into a zombie. So the first thing we're going to do is put liquid latex on Stephanie's face. And using a single ply of toilet paper, we're going to just rough the edges out and start applying the textures to her face. Aside from using toilet paper, there's other things you can use for texturizing skin. Oatmeal works really well. Looks like flaking skin. Corn flakes, again, swell up nicely. Anything that is most pretty much every breakfast cereal will work very nicely on somebody's face. And while we're letting that dry, one thing we're going to start adding in to texturize the skin that is going to be more of a deluxe version is using something called Sin Wax. So I'm going to just make a kind of a small contusion in, because I can get it near her hairline. And this is probably where I want to put the maggots coming from her head. Good idea to use a bread knife as opposed to steak knives. Awesome. Okay, so while that's, you see it is drying up, but I'm just gonna put down one more application of latex over top of the toilet paper to make sure it doesn't appear to look like there's something actually on her face that is all part of the whole thing. While Stephanie is drying up, we're going to be using a product by Meron, a skeleton tri-color palette, which is an oil-based makeup. The same makeup that you use for a skeleton is the same makeup you use for a zombie. All you need is three colors, the black, the white, and the moonlight white. Moonlight white is a color which most represents a pale, dead-looking skin. But we're going to start with the black because we want to get the contours in the face done first. Called nicotine teeth, but also looks like rotting teeth.
The foulest stenches in the air, the funk of 40,000 years, and grisly ghouls from every tomb are closing in to see. Stay alive, your body starts to shiver, for no mere mortal can resist the evil of the thriller.